Dennis here, and welcome to an episode of Space Engineers. Today we're taking a look at 5 mods. The AQD reinforced windows by Anenra, the flat thrusters and the flat survival kit by Sultan MRP, the Ganymede? Something. The Productions mod pack by Sarkinus, and the Zat Desk by Zatum. Is that how you pronounce it? Is that how you pronounce it? I'm weird spelling. Oops. Kind of blinding all of a sudden there. Oopsie. Oh well. So let's first take a look at the flat survival kit. As it is right here. Tell me. First person. No. Wrong button. See it? Just basically a panel. That's flat. We're gonna be a bot. But here, see, that will be healing me and restoring my oxygen and hydrogen. And if you go into the menu, production, survival kit, it has all of the same production items as the normal survival kit. Thus, this will allow you to make more compact ships with a smaller item. Well, these are all flat items. Unfortunately, this is only available on large ships. There are no small ship variants. Now, of all these flat variants that have been coming out lately, you make a really small and compact ship. Especially with thruster. It's annoying. I don't know, what about build cost? Why did it tell me it's build cost? That's a bit weird. There we go. So like 30 steel plates, 2 construction components, 3 medical components, 4 motors, 1 display, and 5 computers. Is that the same as vanilla? Let's find out. Yeah, it's basically vanilla. So if you have a vanilla one of the survival kit down, you just break it down and plop this in its place. It takes up less space. It's a way to save space in your ship. Now let's go over to the flat thrusters. Now these are listed as ion thrusters, they're available in both small and large, but they seem to work in atmosphere just as well as they do in space. It's kind of weird. I'll show you. And you see here, they don't seem to have any limitations compared to their ion counterparts, or the vanilla counterparts. And you can see that both of them have the same output consumption and output. Both use 4.5 megawatts and have a 3.8 meganewtons output. As for the vanilla small, it has less consumption, obviously, and significantly less output because it's only 345.6 kilonewtons. At optimal performance. About a hell load less than this one. However, a large vanilla thruster has a higher output and a much greater consumption. Bloody hell, that's high. But still, it's really high, that one. Greater output, but if you think about it, you can fit 6 of these in the space of one of those. Use up less power than 6 of these use up less power than that, and we'll have an output about, let's say, 4 to 5 times more. So you get a lot more output with these. Break down flat too. So what's your build cost? 75 steel plates, 50 construction components, 25 large steel tubes, and 300 motors. Wait, there's no thruster components. Stop blowing motors. These are just as much components as a vanilla atmospheric, don't they? Oh, even... Oh, we've got some more one there. Oops. That's interesting. Different build cost. But yeah, it would be best to replace all your thrusters with these things. If you're replacing all your small thrusters, then it is going to use up a lot more power. Does it? Hang on, let's check again. Still got a bullet hole in there. Yeah, they use up more power, but obviously it takes up less space and has a higher output. Even the small ships have the same sort of difference. You see, these are 144 kilonewtons with only requiring 100 kilowatts. And compared to the small one, it uses half as much power and puts out significantly more output. 10 times as much output, since its optimal is 14.4. So yeah, that was a little bugger, didn't it? And obviously this one has a max, the large vanilla has max output of 172.8 kilonewtons. So higher output and higher power consumption. The amount of power consumption of one of these is really tiny. Maybe some really tiny drones of these things. Yeah, maybe some tiny drones that can easily fly through an enemy ship. You shouldn't have to risk getting yourself killed. Just send in a couple of drones using these things as its thrusters. Anyway, the build cost. Let me get back to it. Really cheap. So yeah, you can use these as a sort of sacrificial drones. Oh god. Just imagine flying a small drone into an enemy ship that contains nothing but warheads. So all you need is one reactor, one gyroscope, and the warhead in the middle. You just plop your thrusters around on the sides, a remote control block and an antenna. You just control a little drone floating through an enemy ship, and boom! Damn. Deadly! Noodle. Next, we should move on to the desk. After that, it's actually quite simple and easy to go through. See, we just have a desk. Got some similar designs to vanilla, but a lot smoother because it's designed more to be put together with other pieces to make a bigger desk. So you've got the simple straight one. This is a centerpiece. You know how to go in between them. In fact, its name is Desk Leveled Block. And here you have a corner piece with no chair. Then a corner piece with a chair. Or inner corners. You got an outer corner. Another outer corner with a chair. Huh. Just notice that bit there. Links up with all the others. This is just like a normal desk with no chair. And merged together, you can get a conference table of 16. Neat. You need all sorts of different combinations if you wanted to. You could even have most of these blank with no chairs and have it seem like the chairs can move around to get to the other spots. Fine. Okay. And as you can also see, they're available for small ships. Now, unlike a lot of mods that have large blocks available in the small ship variant, they're just simply scaled down, these ones actually modified in a much different way. You see, the edges on the corners are a lot smaller. This white desk is thinner, because they're all 3x3 floor space. And then the centerpiece is just a single cube. Well, two cubes stacked on top of each other. But still, it only takes up a single cube on floor space. And that one is a straight piece, similar to that. But it only takes up a single cube floor space, thus allowing you to have much more intricate designs for your desk and tables. I didn't even check that build cost, did I? Yeah, just interior plates and construction components. Quite a few of some of them. No, that's just 5 interior plates, so that's cheap. Yeah, the ones that don't have chairs usable less interior plates than the ones that do. Yeah, see? A lot less pieces. Ow. I've linked up. So anyway, how about we now take a look at the reinforced windows. These things are cool. We've already seen them. See, it's just basically the same sort of windows, but buffed out a bit. Well, I wish I could explain it. They stick out more compared to the vanilla variants, which allows you to make much cooler cockpits. So this one would just be a flat glass, and you have to use other pieces to, you know, make it stick out a bit more. But this one actually has a bit to it already. And you got this one. You got the side panels. Both these are two different blocks. I just put them together because it's easier to place down this version when it's actually attached to something. Same over here. These two are different blocks, it's just easier to plop it down when it's attached to something. So you got both of those, and then you got your flat piece. As you can already tell, it's available for both large and small ships. Right. Is there a difference between build cost? 32 bulletproof glass, 20 girders, and 40 steel plates. Yeah, they all have different build costs depending on their shape. Both the same shape but different angles, they have the same build cost. Yeah. Then we've got the small ship variants here. Which, the small ship versions are probably going to be the ones used most. You know, to make your small ships look a bit cooler. But I do think these look a lot cooler than just using vanilla windows. You guys agree? I might actually go ahead and modify some of my other designs. When I can be bothered to. yeah. And not only that, they are meant to be more durable than vanilla. So, how about we place down you? Do that. Get up the gun. Will this really be a fair test, considering this isn't a vanilla weapon? I got all these other sort of weapons. Yeah, all sorts of different vanilla weapons. I'm actually glad they are adding new weapons to the game. They've even renamed them all. Anyway, let's just use this one. So, it's a quick fire. That's 3 hits. That's 3 hits there. Now let's see which one's taking the most damage. Vanilla is taking 4% damage. This one, so I'm taking 3% damage. And we'll only need 2 bulletproof glass to be fully repaired. Oh, they're both only need 2. Can't remember if I hit one more than the other. So yeah, it has a lot more durability to it. So not only does it look better than using vanilla, it's also more safer. But it'll keep you protected from more bullets. And I think it is recolorable, and you can change its skin. I rarely ever check if you can change the skins of these blocks. Yeah, you can change its skin. So you can have all sorts of different designs. I can change the skins of this lot. Good. Now what about the flat ones? Yeah. And you? I guess it's just normal to make it so it can. Yeah. Let's head back to normal. For now. Wrong button. Anyway. Now we've looked at all these. How about we move over to the production thing? And which is the that thing, tech production mod pack. So I put vanilla storage down as well as the modded ones, because they have the similar sized containers with the same conveyor points, so you can just do a quick swap. Now these things contain a hell load more storage capacity than the vanilla. So first, let's take a look at the small one's capacity of 74,087.99. As for vanilla, it's around 15,000. Close to 16,000. That's a big one. Over 2 mil! And vanilla is only 421,875. Did I say 0.01 litres? Yeah, it says 0.01 at the end. Random. Alright. What about fuel cost? Alrighty then. Yeah, it's a hell of a lot more expensive too. That's a feature I didn't know they added. Hold shift and scroll down the list. It's got number two. There you go. Let's move on to the others. Now these three are the upgrade modules. You have increasing speed, yield, and efficiency, or power. Like this one is the efficiency module. And for a 20% power efficiency rating. And this one does 25% to the speed. Let's see, all the different shapes on the inside. And we got this one, which is the yield module, that gives you 20% higher yield, which is pretty handy. See this yellow bit, well, that circles, that's where you connect it to the things. And then here, we have the basic assembler. It does whatever the basic assembler would do. Grab that stuff. Then we got the modded assembler, which can do everything. Now for the modded one, it has two less upgrade slots compared to the vanilla. Look down here, it only has six. The vanilla has eight of all four sides. With this one, these tiny circles are the module points, where you can attach the modules to improve its performance. These bigger circles are conveyor points, meaning unlike the vanilla assembler, the conveyors cannot be blocked by, well, can be blocked, but you don't gain anything by blocking them with the upgrades. Unless those upgrades are on a different assembler. Because yeah, you can put this one here, and put another one on this block here, the other way up, and thus the modules for each of them can be in between. I'm gonna put one down there as an example. Head back to here. That's a cargo container. Alrighty then. Speed for you. Speed for you. Yeah, like that. See what is blue that's actually attached. And you can have six of these on instead of just four. Which will allow it to become much faster. Why are 175? Frick! Now what you have? Huh. That's weird. Does it have some special properties that make it go up even higher? Oh, weird. Oh well. So they're build cost? I never checked these ones build cost, did I? Yeah, about... Well, they're all bloody expensive, that's for sure. I think the efficiency module may be the cheapest. And these power cells. Superconductors on that one. Does it have many uniques? Now it's not exactly the cheapest, but I think it's just as much as vanilla, maybe? And I think the assemblers and refineries are similar in cost to their vanilla counterparts. So this is a basic refinery. Just does all the basic refinery stuff. And then we got this thing, which is the full assembler. Which only has 6 slots instead of 8. Yeah, for the same reason that its accompanying modules only need 1 slot. So yeah, it's big. Looks more like a computer case from here. All 6 slots are on the back there. I do have to admit that the assembler and the refineries kind of look like computer cases. It's kind of amusing, really. Here, yeah, we got the conveyor port to put stuff in. And a larger inventory space than vanilla, too. That's interesting. One little thing I forgot to take a look at when I was poking around at them. Oh, the inventory size is different based on their size. Interesting. I say, you're an expensive bugger. Gravity components? Wait. Why? Only 3. Which one is gravity? Does vanilla? No. Yeah, they're basically the same cast. Apart from the larger ones. The full ones. One needs slightly few more materials. And more motors. Oh my. Apart from needing less computers, it needs more of everything else. It needs more computers. It's more of everything. Apart from steel plates. I guess it must work on materials faster than vanilla? Probably. Anyway, this video has gone on for quite a bit. So I think it might be best if I end this one here. And I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you have, please leave a like and even subscribe for episodes. And I shall see you all next time. Bye bye.